didn't already.
You like the cold weather? I like both. I like both. It's always so sunny that sometimes it's nice to have a little bit of rain or a little bit of dark clouds sometimes, right? So, how's everyone today? Everyone's good?
Yeah.
It's good. It's Thursday. Tomorrow's Friday. So we feel good.
That's all.
What?
That's all.
That's all?
That's all.
That's all. That's all, folks.
That's all.
Right?
That's all.
So,
the German part.
So, I was, last night I was showing my girlfriend this video I had to do for college, and my professor made me learn to juggle. He made me learn to juggle, so that's something that I can do. I can juggle. Something interesting, right? Can anyone in here juggle? Has anyone ever tried? No? So that's something interesting, right, that not many people can do. Right? So I was thinking, why don't we try to think of something that you can do, that you think is the most interesting thing that you can do, or that you have been able to do since a certain
example.
Age, right? So my example was juggling, right? I can juggle, I have been able to juggle for around 8 years now. But it can be anything, something that you can do that maybe you think is rare, and something interesting, give us something interesting, right? So, we'll take a minute to think about it. Take a minute to think about it, we'll discuss it. Any ideas?
Something we can...
Something you can do. Is there anything you can do that you find interesting?
I can drive.
You can what?
Drive.
I can drive a car.
You can.
I can.
Can, in America. That's interesting. But most people can drive, right? Can you guys drive?
Yes.
Can you think of anything else that you're able to do, maybe?
I can light the candle.
Or the
candle. Very good. Very good. What, can you say it again one more time?
I can light the candle.
You're
right.
Can
light the
candle. So tell us about that.
I know.
Has anyone ridden a camel?
No.
Do you mind telling us about it?
The first, that's very difficult. Because it's go like down, then it's go up, and you feel sometimes you feel down.
So, and are there anything else? Like, do you wear a seat? Do you have to wear like a strap or anything?
You need to. You need one.
Okay.
It's not necessary, but you can if you want like to wear like a jacket or something like that.
Okay. And then what about, do you have a camel?
Yes, I
have. So, how many do you
have?
Yeah,
how
turning.
Much?
Each one? $300,000.
Really?
$300,000.
And he has
30.
What's that?
$9 million in cash.
What's
rich man, just in cash.
Camels?
Yeah.
Magatir.
Just one name.
And me, like. And.
A dirty name.
Yeah, you know, some of them, like the special one.
The special.
Say.
How do you use the
camels? You make money or spend money?
Sorry?
On it?
We use it for everything.
The eat.
We can eat, we can drink the milk. We can carry, and for the racing.
Oh, and what do you do with these camels, of these things?
Party.
Camel party.
You make money or spend, or only spend money?
No, spend, and sometimes we sell the camel.
Okay. And do you drink the meat?
Yes, it's very good. And it's very good for the health. The first time, you will have a problem with your stomach. Because it's very strong. But
okay.
Next time,
it'll
be okay.
It has a lot of fat.
No, fat, and there's like a salt.
Okay.
Salt?
Interesting.
Yeah. So you have it in when you're in Saddam, you drink a camembert?
Yeah.
And how many times per day do you have to collect your milk? Once over a day?
No, maybe twice a month.
Oh, twice a month.
Not
so much.
Yeah, not so much.
And you eat even?
Yeah. It's very good.
It's good.
Really?
Good, the meat.
It's edible. You eat a lot.
Yeah, it's very
maybe
big.
Maybe one.
Maybe one every 2 months.
Yeah. Fine. And you give water, please. What do you need?
That's it, like grass and water.
So he can ride camels, he can drink camel
milk.
You
can eat camel milk.
And you've been able to do this for how long? The riding?
I learned for 2 years.
2 years?
Yeah.
So that was a good one.
And can you do racing with that?
Yeah.
Really? Is it dangerous, I think so?
No.
No?
That's it.
Do you have a seat to sit on it?
Yeah, you can put the like the maximum.
And then you have the
interesting.
But they are very tall.
No, no. Not
too
much.
Not too much.
Like there is like stairs to go.
Very good. So that was something that he can do that I would find rare, right? None of us have done that. So do we have any other ideas? Anything else? Anything interesting you maybe learned as a child or recently? No? Okay. So I liked the camel. That was very, very good. The camel example. That was a rare thing. That's something that he can do, something that he was able to do, right? Something very rare that we don't do in many countries, right? Is that popular anywhere else? No? I've actually never really, I don't know if I've ever even seen a camel, actually. Has everyone here seen a camel?
Yes.
You've seen it?
Yes, when I was in I went in Dubai and they let me climb on it, but I wasn't there. It was a touristic
thing.
In Zoom?
I was very worried.
Why were you worried?
Because they are huge. It's a big animal. And it moves like this.
Yeah.
Like what?
You sit and it moves like this.
Ah,
and
slant it down.
The movement.
The sensation is that you are falling down easily.
So that was something that he can do, something that he was able to do. That was a very good example. Thank you for sharing that. I can do the juggling. I'll do that for you one day. I'm going to bring in some juggling balls for you, right? So, I wrote a sentence here. They blank wait because they were in a hurry. Can you guys think of what might be in that blank there?
They can't wait.
They can't wait.
They can't wait because, but, now look at this word here. Right? So that's past, right?
Oh.
So it wouldn't be can't. It's close. Very close.
Couldn't,
right? Couldn't. Very good. Couldn't, right? Have we seen that before?
Yeah?
Couldn't? Was that on the one of the recent tests that you took?
No, just the recent.
The what?
The lesson of today.
Oh, okay.
Shoot down, cool down.
Today?
Yeah. The bus.
That was another one that you did recently. Okay. So, what are these called? Do we know what these are called?
Like the
model verbs. Very good.
Yeah.
Model verbs. Abdul's on it. Abdul's on it. He knows. So, what do we use model verbs for? Okay. We use them for what else?
When you're not sure.
So we can use, well, the model verbs are used for forming tenses or moods or voices. They can express necessity, possibility. Can you give me examples of model verbs?
Hypothetical situation.
Right, yes, exactly, yes. Very good. Can we think of any examples of model verbs? Other ones than this? Should, right?
Would.
Ought.
So we have should, would. What were the other ones?
Most. Ought. O-U-G-H-T. Ought.
Oh, like you ought to?
Ought to.
Okay. Ought. That's another one. Any other ones?
Have to?
No.
What is the
might.
What is the present form of the could?
Can.
Okay, so can.
Can, may, must.
May, must. Very
might.
Good.
Might.
So we've seen these. Good. So we've seen these before. So do we know the rules like for can and could? How about can? So we said can is what tense? What tense is can?
Is it simple? Isn't simple.
Very good. Can, so we use can with the present simple. So that's why here we didn't use that because of the word, right? What about, so that's very good. So what about the able to? When can we use able to? You know, but you can use the can for present form, right? But you can also use it for, so the past or the conditional we went over, right, is the couldn't. Could, that's the past, right? Can you use it as a conditional before I move on to able to? Like a could. How would you use that in a conditional sentence?
They could be wait.
They could
be waiting.
Be waiting. They could be waiting. Okay. So you could be waiting for, what, 10 minutes?
Yeah.
Could be waiting for
one day,
right? So 1 day. So anything from there, you could be waiting, you're saying? So it's a possibility? Okay, very good. And then what about able to? So when do we use able to?
When you can do something.
Okay. In what tense would we use it?
Are you able to
swim?
To swim?
Okay. Are you able to swim? And so we would be talking about the. Can we use it in another tense that we would be talking about?
Are you able to speak English?
Are you able to speak English? What about the future? Can we use that in the future?
Future.
Will be able. So in a sentence.
Will or won't.
In a sentence, maybe. Maybe a question.
In 6 months, I will be able to speak English.
In 6 months, I will be able to speak English. Is that a true sentence?
No. I may.
May?
Maybe.
Maybe.
Always. So I will be able to, right?
I'm supposed to speak English.
Supposed to. So so you could say you will be able to practice English in the United States. So it would be like the future tense. So we would use that for the future. Good. So we've seen this before, right? All right. You guys seem pretty comfortable with that. I brought in this communication exercise that we could do. And so what it does is it lists off sentences and beliefs using can, could, and be able to, right? So these are possibilities. These are things that we can do, right? Things that we can do. And so what it does is it lists it off, and you read it, and then you say if you agree or you disagree. So the first one is, to be able to speak English well, you have to live in an English-speaking country for at least 1 year. So you can write, you can put an X if you agree, or you can put an A if you would like, and a D if you disagree. So if you wouldn't mind just going through, writing an A or a D on each one, and then after you finish, we can talk about if we agree or we disagree with the whole class. Because some of these, I think, we will have different opinions on. Here we go. give it another 2 minutes and then we will see what everyone thinks. So let's look into these. So again, remember these are abilities or possibilities using can, could, or be able to, right? Because that's what they show, an ability or a possibility, right? So Anna, would you mind reading one?
To be able to speak English well, you have to live in an English-speaking country for at least 1 year.
So what do you think? Do you agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Disagree?
Yeah, I think it depends on how you work on it.
Too much?
Yeah.
Okay. Does anyone else have
it? It depends. If you start from zero, maybe you'll start from 1 year.
Yeah.
If you start from a basic level, I think 6 months you can do a good job.
6 months?
And then you have to work maybe by other systems.
If you never have no nothing about the language,
yeah.
maybe
yeah.
1 year is
good.
That's good.
But if you start from
okay. Does everyone agree with that? Do we have anyone that thinks differently? Or does everyone have the same idea? Vincent and Zavon, same thing?
Yeah, I disagree.
Okay, same thing?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so let's move on to the next one. Vince, would you mind reading two there?
I prefer your more opportunities if you can speak English well. I agree.
Agree?
Yeah.
Okay. And why?
Because now a lot of company multinational,
yeah.
And it depends of your job, but if you want to travel, to be more valuable in the market,
mm-hmm.
You need to speak.
Okay.
I agree.
Does everyone agree?
Yes.
Any other additional reasons or the same thoughts?
So there is the global company. The most important company is a global company. And if you can speak in English, you are able to talk for manager, director, or CEO, whatever. If you can't speak in English or understand nothing, you are don't have chance. Maybe the always, maybe in Brazil, have a lot of needs or important person in English. If you can understand, it's not good.
Okay.
Or it's have a problem.
Okay.
If you want to speak, and if you can understand and can speak a little bit, it's enough.
Okay. So we think that if you can speak English well, then there are more opportunities, right? So we see the word can there. So if you have the ability to speak English, right? What about, Salam, what did you think of three? Or would you mind reading that too?
Agree.
And would you mind reading it?
It's never too late to be able to learn a new language.
Okay.
Yeah.
And does everyone agree?
I'm never.
And why do we agree with that?
Because if you want to learn.
Never late. To learn all things.
Yeah.
It's never late, but when you're left, when you're dead, it's too late.
Okay, so
it's sometimes it's late.
But I'm not sure.
Philosophical.
If this works, because the sentence is to be able to learn a new language. If you are 70 years old, I don't know if you are in the same way able to learn a language.
I should be able,
like,
but more difficult than you
more difficult,
was younger.
Yes, more,
more difficult, but.
There's a will, okay, and maybe you can learn the language, but not as well as when you were 20 years old. In the same way, it doesn't work anymore.
Of course, more difficult, yes. But
I took both.
You took both? No, I like
agree and disagree. Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Because if you want to learn a language, you can make it with 80 years or with 100 years.
Yeah.
Sure, but not in the same way as...
Yeah.
With 20 years.
Yeah.
If you really want it, or even more.
Yeah.
But we are talking about learning a language.
Yeah,
yeah. Once the younger if you are, it's more easy, it's more possibility, less time, or spend less money.
Very good point. So you highlighted the be able to, right?
Yeah.
So that was the point there, be able to. And I can see her point, like you said, right? Maybe when you get older, it's harder to be able to. Good point. Abdul, would you mind reading the next one there?
My main reason for learning English is because I want to able to get a good job.
Okay.
I disagree.
You disagree?
Yeah, you disagree. Because now the English is the international language. Everybody speaks English.
Okay.
For everything.
Good. So we will, I'm going to talk about that a little later too. So that was a very good point, very good point.
You're disagreeing with this?
Yes, disagree.
And you want to be a pilot?
Yeah.
No only job. Is
yes.
That's the only job. Because
no
main
reason.
Okay.
Because you can't walk if you don't have English.
Very good. What about the next one there, Julia?
It doesn't matter if you make mistakes in English, if people are able to understand you.
Yes,
I agree.
Yeah.
Because
language,
I don't speak.
If you speak and if you try and if you don't.
It's more easy you speak for other foreign.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if you want to the Germany, I speak in English and German people, you can understand me more than Americans or England. But it depends on the whole formal is the moment, or interview, or for the job.
Yeah.
You need to...
You can play
you need to... You don't have mistakes. But if you travel or speak for someone for another foreign, it's more easy to understand.
Okay, so you
your future job.
Very good point.
Please.
So you want people to understand you. You want people to understand you, right? But if you go to a job or something, then they will highlight or point out the mistakes that you make. Is that what you're saying? Good. What about Luciano or Marco? Would you mind reading the next one?
There's not much you can to improve your English outside the classroom. Disagree.
Disagree.
Yeah, I have a lot of websites to help you.
What
to learn
movies?
Yeah.
Movies.
Listen to music.
Yeah, music.
Yeah.
Okay. So you disagree?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Does everyone think the same?
Yeah.
You agree with that? Okay. What about the next one there, Julia?
Tourists should always be able to say some basic phrases in the language of the country they are visiting. I agree.
Agree.
Totally agree, yeah.
Because it's a kind of respect I show the people of the country I visit. It's always better if you can say hello, thank you, how are you,
yes.
To talk a little bit and to learn a little bit of the culture of the country.
Some polite phrases or some for thank you, how are you, I mean the native.
How do you say hello in German?
Hmm?
How do you say hello?
Guten Tag.
Hello.
Hello.
It's easy. Hello.
Yeah.
It's just hello.
Guten Tag.
We can remember that one, right?
Guten Tag. Yeah, that's
what?
Yeah.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
Okay, so let's but let's stick to English, right? So does everyone agree with that? You disagree?
Yeah. I was in Spain and I can't speak Spanish.
Yeah.
I know,
but
it
wouldn't be better if you could speak Spanish. If you could say hola, que tal.
I spoke only English.
Okay.
Vodka. Probably when you go to
Chinese
or Chinese, you can't speak this song.
But you
can
before you travel into a book and learn just 2, 3, 4 sentences, no?
No.
That's every language?
That's
so
nice.
What do we think of the next one there? So what about the next one there, Anna?
A person can never be 100% bilingual.
Okay.
I think it's true.
You think it's true?
Yeah.
And why?
100% language that you assume when you are born there. Very, very, very difficult to be 100% bilingual. I
disagree
also.
Disagree.
Yeah.
Disagree.
Yeah. You can't speak two languages. For
example,
my daughter or cousin, he was born here, and she speaks. She speaks perfectly in French.
Okay.
Because she watches TV in French, she speaks with their mother in French, and at school she speaks English.
Okay.
Like your kid, they speak Italian?
Oh, it's cool, they speak perfectly Italian, but they are speaking English, but it is not their language, even if they stay near 10 years.
No,
for
example,
we learn better and better.
Brazil speaks very good English.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe she lost some words in Portuguese, I think.
So we think. So when we say we disagree, we would say we can't. We would say it's impossible.
No, yes, you
can.
Are you
saying
we
can't? Disagree.
I disagree.
Can never.
So that's why I wanted to point that out, right?
Yeah.
So you understand that it says can never, right?
I lost.
So we say a person can never, right? So that would be the opposite, right? What about the next one there, Abdul?
Most people prefer to see a forget movie, forget film with subtitles than see it. Deep German into their own language. Now they watch it in English and then an English subtitle, both in English or like that.
Okay.
Or what? I don't understand.
Okay. You don't understand the what? Okay.
You prefer film in English than Arabic
films. Of course.
No, because you are studying English.
Yeah.
You never want or need to
studying.
Right, so
you're staying at home, you're putting the American flag.
I see it in Arabic.
Very good.
But I like to see it from English.
Okay.
I prefer it.
Does everyone agree with that?
Oh, I disagree.
You disagree?
Yeah, I prefer it. My language is more easy. But
yeah.
I prefer
when you
my
watch
old language.
Okay.
Yeah.
You prefer
my language and put W in English or whatever language.
Okay. Very good. What about the next one there, Savan? What does that say there? 10?
The internet can help you when you learn English. That's true.
True.
Yeah. Agreed.
Everyone?
Yeah.
Okay, so it can. So then you're saying it's possible, it's able
yeah
to help you?
Yeah,
of course.
Okay.
Every day.
Everything you need.
I would have to agree,
yeah,
right?
Yes.
What about the next one there, Anna?
Listening to other people speaking English is the only way I can improve my pronunciation.
No, the only way?
It's not the only way. You can watch movies, you can
yeah
listen to music,
yeah,
you can.
Yeah.
So
make American friends or
you listen music and when you watch TV, you listen.
Someone
who's
talking.
Person.
Yeah, but you, I mean, I think it was listening has to be in person, not
people.
Okay.
Speak.
If you mean like that, it's true.
So we have different thoughts,
yeah,
different opinions
no
there?
Because he considers that
if
movie and the music
you,
is something coming from people. So he says, you are listening to people.
To people.
Ah, I see. Always thinking like an attorney, I see.
He's a Swiss, he has to be precise.
So, but that is listening to people through
the
media.
Big watch,
oh,
it's a
you
know,
disagree?
Okay.
Because you can just see the phonetic to
okay
understand.
No.
Oh, you can.
Okay. And then what about the next one? What about the next one there, Julia?
Most young people in my country can communicate well in English. Yes, I agree.
Yeah.
Everyone?
No, unfortunately no. I can't say the same in every
country. They can't. So you would say the opposite of can, right?
Yeah,
they
can't.
Can't? Okay. They can't. And most people you said in Italy cannot?
No.
Oh, okay.
Unfortunately, no. They're doing bad programs, school programs, they're very bad. They just learn a few things, stupid things.
Okay. In other countries, are you saying they can?
Maybe the young have
interest
to learn.
So how long? At what age do they learn
about
English?
I have 12 nieces.
Ten years old.
Speak almost.
So you would say she what? Can, could, or has been able to? And she, but you would say she, if you said she blank since she was maybe 5 or 6 years old? So she can, could, or be able to, you said?
She can.
Well, Ken would be more present, right?
Yeah.
So we're talking about the past, right? Or in the future, but you could say she, what, has been...
Mm-hmm.
Right? Has been able to speak English since she was maybe 5? What about...
It's the difficult point.
Does everyone agree that's possible?
So people don't just child can learn English just by watching TV in English. No, not just.
Okay.
Have another way.
So that's not possible.
Yeah.
So you would say a child, so then how would you reword that sentence? A child
can't,
right?
Yeah.
Can't
yeah,
learn
can.
English by just watching TV in English. Very good. What about 14 there, Vince?
A good teacher can influence how much you enjoy a language.
Yes.
English.
Sure.
I agree.
We agree?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. And why do we say that?
A good teacher, the chance if you learn easy or fast is
more interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. Very good point. Very good point. So they have a lot of, they can, or they are able to control that, influence that. And then the last one there, Julia.
To be able to communicate well in a foreign language, pronunciation and vocabulary are more important than grammar. I disagree. Because you need the grammar to make the sentences right.
To communicate.
So.
What do we think?
But you need to know the grammar because you need to know the situation, the tense if you are in the past or the present or the future. If you know use will about the future, is so you know use the verb in the past to talk about the past, maybe the other people can't understand.
Yeah.
Or
so the question is
yeah,
to be able to communicate
yeah,
well.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. Maybe this depends. Maybe here that they both are.
Okay.
In my opinion, I don't know.
Very good.
You can communicate. Or you talk that before. If you talk to another foreign, it's more easy to
yeah.
understand the one of them. But it's important to know the grammar too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very good. Very good. So.
In my case, I studied English when I was a child, and then I never used it to communicate.
Okay.
And, I have one aunt to live in Canada. I have uncles and cousins, and I can't talk to them, and I'm feeling bad. And my siblings know studied them child. And I come here sometimes a year, and I go, come on, I don't know English, why? And I need to, I can't listen, I can understand, but I can't speak.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, I need to study.
So would you be able to talk to
When I arrived here, I'm nothing to grammar. Zero. My grammar was zero. And now I stay here for 3 months.
Okay.
I'm very proud of my grammar because I improved a lot. I didn't love to take a... I think my teacher helped me a lot. Sandy.
Mm-hmm.
She's a very good teacher. She writes on the board a lot. It's very good for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I go back to Brazil.
Very good. So is there a condition that would be met for you to speak with your family
yeah.
better?
Yeah. My family.
So you would say to my
friends in Brazil or in another meeting.
And it was your aunt or your sister again? What was it, your sister or your aunt?
No, my aunt.
Your aunt?
Yeah, living in Canada.
And cousins.
And cousins.
Okay.
You say... Aunt or aunt?
Aunt.
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 Aunt. Because aunt is...
So that brings up a perfect sentence, right? So you would say, I blank speak English with my aunt if I learned English. If I learned English, right? So this is a condition. The condition is if I learned English, right? So what would you put here? Could, right? Very good, could. So that's why we can use could as a condition, right? I could speak English with my aunt if I learned English. I can't speak English with her because I don't learn, I do not know English, or I did not. So in the past, you would say, you would have said, I can't speak English with my aunt because I don't know English. And then you would say, well, I could speak English with my aunt if I learned English, right? And so that's how that works, exactly. So, one of the last things I wanted to do was I wanted you to think on this topic. I wanted you to think of the two or three most important things in order that you will be able to do, that you will be able to do after learning English. To you, what are the three most important, two or three most important things in order?
You can also change your sentence. If I had learned English, I may be able to speak with my pen.
But you said had, so that would be,
yeah.
you would have to say, I might, if I had learned English, I might have been able to. But you're changing the tense, right?
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. So, I want you to think of the, I want you to think of the two or three most important things that you will be able to do. So again, that's the future, right? After learning English. Is it, so I'll give you an example. Maybe it is, I will be able to get a better job. I will be able to make more friends. I will be able to travel. I will be, so like those types of examples. What will you be able to do after learning English because you learned English? So I'll give you just a few minutes, just two or three minutes, and maybe 3 or 4 minutes to think about that. So let's go over the examples that you guys had there for the two or three most important things after you learn the English language. So, what did you guys have?
A good job. Yeah, applied for many jobs.
Travel.
Okay.
And myself.
So travel, good job, and yourself. In that order, travel, good job, and yourself.
Good job is the first.
Good job is the first.
No. For travel.
For travel.
For me,
it's for travel.
For traveling?
Yeah.
Okay.
For travel, communicate with the
person.
Okay, so you can get a good job, you can travel, you can talk to people, so you want to be able to, you want to be able to, right? So without that, would you say that you can't? Without the English language?
Yeah, I can.
Okay. What other things do we have? The same?
Yeah, but I can research a job without speaking English, but I never go out, I think.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any other ideas?
Traveling, talking with foreign people, getting new jobs.
Okay. So so we all have the same idea, so we want to be able to get a good job, travel, and talk to people,
yeah.
I would say. Okay, good. So we want to be able to do that, and after we learn, we can do that, right?
Yeah.
Good. All right, so today we went over can, we went over be able to, we went over could, and those show what? What do they, show possibility, and opportunities, and abilities. Very good. All right, guys. So that will be the end of the class today. I think everyone did very well. Thank you, guys. And guys, I will see you tomorrow.
Yeah.
I will see you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Have a good day.
Bye-bye.